lot of people, when they think of Russia, they think of communism. Well, it's not communist anymore, it's a democracy. We also tend to picture those old world chubby babushkas. I was just flown to Russia to speak in front of 7,000 people at the country's first vegetarian festival, and wow, those people are beautiful. They are thin, healthy, and very blonde. I was told the word Rus means blonde, and they weren't kidding. Most of them don't go to doctors or use drugs or pills. Why? Because life is a lot simpler in Russia, and they make very little money, so they have to grow their own food, and they can't afford pesticides, so they're a lot healthier. Sometimes a meal can be this simple. The event took place at a huge 300-acre international cultural center being built 2 hours outside of Moscow called Ethnomir, designed to celebrate cultural diversity and world health, and ultimately unite the world, all set in a beautiful natural setting with big hotels and even bigger cafeterias that serve vegetarian food. There were morning meditations and a cultural coming together that truly makes you feel the world is finally becoming one. I spoke on three different panels about how true health is the connection of body, mind, and spirit through raw food, healthy relationships, life values, and the interconnectedness of all living things. I met with government officials.
Marcus Rothgrantz, and I'm with the minister.
The minister is over there, but I am deputy of government.
Deputy of government for Ethnomir.
And Ethnomir itself.
It's somewhere in Russia. And we're here at the festival, and I'm just helping to promote how important it is that people are healthy in this world.
Right. Yes.
Thank you for helping to promote this.
Yes.
Yes. Thanks
a lot.
Okay, thank you.
They were really curious. Russian scientists hooked up medical testing equipment to see exactly how healthy a raw foodist like me was. And they were very excited, to say the least. I tested better than everyone else they tested. My readings were that of someone in their 30s, even though I am almost 50. It showed my energy and vitality levels were 3 times that of a normal person. It even showed I had extremely high psychic abilities and did great on tests given to Russian astronauts. They desperately wanted my book and DVDs translated in Russian so they would know my raw food secrets, and I definitely plan on doing that.
He was in the Second World War. He was also a political prisoner for 10 years. The guy's been through a lot, and he's like a little fireball. He's almost 91 years old, and he's been raw vegan for over 40 years. So he's living proof that you can actually live really well for a long, long time eating this way. His name is what's your name?
My name is Vahe Danielyan, my boy.
Danielyan. Okay, that's his name. So
Daniel, you know Daniel, Daniel.
Dan. His name's Dan. Okay.
Almost half a century, I live on a live fruit, a live food, you know, fruits and vegetables, etc., nuts, etc. That's all. And I forgot about illnesses, diseases, about pains, etc.
He's an amazing guy. He's full of energy.
I love Russia. This just goes to prove, whatever in life you fear or don't understand, get to know it. It could turn out to be something wonderful and amazing.
Hello from Russia.